welcome. Today I'm going to be in the garden and I've got lots of little jobs to be getting on with. Hopefully finish off some of the bigger jobs that I haven't got around to finishing. But let's start with those broad beans I was talking about in my last vlog. So here are the broad beans. They haven't grown hugely big, but they will grow a lot more. But they have got flowers already on them. And now that I'm looking at them, they're all looking pretty good plants. And the last time I was talking about them, I said I was going to get rid of one half of them, didn't I? So I was looking to keep this half down here because these have slightly more flowers on them. But now I'm looking at them, I think I'm going to keep them all. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some from this side just to plug in the gaps on this side, because I think these ones look neater and they haven't grown as big, so they'll be easier to stake. And then hopefully this side will transplant okay and they'll be all right in their new home. But I'm not sure how well they'll transplant because they are quite big plants at the moment. But let's go on and do that. Well, after much umming and ahhing about what I was going to do with the beans, I didn't do what I said I was going to do. I'll show you what I did in the end. I have split the beans into two sections because when I looked at the beans, both this side and the far side had some really good beans in them, but the middle section was a bit wafty. So I thought, right, well, I'll move some of the middle section and fill in the gaps that had occurred. So these two plants here have been filled in. This one looks like it's done okay and is settling, and this one with its droopy down leaves looks like it's struggling. I don't know if that's going to take to the transplant, but it's still there for now. And similarly with this one, this transplant doesn't look like it did very well. But these two here, this one and this one, it does look like it did okay. And how I moved them was to take as big a root ball as I could and then dig a hole and just planted them that way. Another job I got done was to run in the irrigation system. So I run in the irrigation system like up and around there and back down, and then onto this bed as well. So it goes up and around and back down and then around, and that bit will feed off and come up to these beds, and then the other bit will come down to here and we'll go into those beds. I've left this long section here basically because where this bit is, there's no chance of any dirt getting in the end. Whereas if I cut that bit off and I don't do anything with it for a bit, there's more chance of dirt getting in and it clogging when I come to use the irrigation system. This bed here is where I have my first early swift potatoes that you would have seen me planting, and you can see that the potatoes are coming through now. So what I need to do is just put a mound of compost on top of there essentially, and that will be like I'm earthing it up, but it will also it'll be fresh compost, so it will add nutrients to that bed as well. So hopefully it'll be a win-win and it'll stop the potatoes from going green. And then another job I've got to do is to sort out this bed here, because it's really got quite weedy and you can't see the definition between the bed and the lawn so much anymore. So I just need to go over and redefine that and pull up all those weeds over there. And if I'm lucky, I might even end up with a couple of leeks there that look like they've grown in amongst those weeds and foxgloves. And then I've also got last year's beans to pull out and last year's cosmos to remove. And then hopefully I will get around to fixing these posts into the compost heaps over there. So those are the jobs I shall be tackling tomorrow, hopefully. And I'm not going to do any more tonight because I'm tired, and usually that's when you make mistakes, and I kind of want to make sure that I weed that bed really thoroughly and I do the compost heaps as well as I can do, so I don't want to really do it tonight. I think I'm better off going in and making some supper for the children and myself and my husband and tackling it again tomorrow. So I'll catch you soon. I happily got the jobs that I was talking about done, and now I'm at my compost heaps debating what to do, and I think I've changed my mind again and I'm going to go for lids on the compost heaps and not a roof. So I'll show you what I'm talking about now. Here are the compost heaps, and I've just put what was going to be the lid or the roof just rested on top for the time being. So if I do that, then you can see that there's the compost heap. And what I think I'm going to do is cut this across here. So I essentially split it in half, and then that half will have a hinge so that bit can move up like that, and this bit will have a hinge so this bit will move up like that. And similarly with this side. And then hopefully that means that when it comes to turning the compost heap, I should just be able to pull up the first half, and that should give me enough room to turn this heap into the next heap, and vice versa when I want to turn that heap into that heap. So I've changed my mind again, and now I'm going with the lid. Definitely, finally, I'm going with the lid. I was a bit concerned with the roof, that if we had really strong gusts of wind, it would just blow it over, and I thought I'd better not take the risk. So I'm going to go with the lid and the hinges, and hopefully it shouldn't be too tricky for me to turn the heap. And I'm not going to do it today because I need to go and get the hinges, and I'm off to Wales tomorrow to visit my family, so I don't want to start a job and leave it halfway through. And I've got some potatoes I need to plant before I go, so we'll go and get on with that. And also I'll show you the progress I made this morning, which you just saw in the montage, but I'll show you the end product now. I earthed up my swift potatoes, and now it looks like 8 little molehills all in a row, but hopefully they'll just exclude the light from getting through the potatoes and turning the potatoes green. And then this bit makes me happy because I just really like it when things look neat and tidy. And all that I need to do with this now is to just put a top dressing of compost. It does need some fresh compost on it, because it's not really that far off the ground, this bed, so it could do with a bit of extra fertilizer. And I have got a few leeks over there. How good they will be, I don't know, because the leeks here did get allium leek miner at the end of last season, so I'm not sure if they will be any good, but hopefully we'll have some bonus leeks. And then I managed to clear this little patch here, which will have my bellotti beans this year. I just need to add some more compost here. I'll do that when I'm more closer to planting out the beans, but I'm very happy with this area now. It all looks tidier. The cold frame has been emptied. I do need to clean the cold frame and clean the greenhouse, but I'm not doing that today. That's too big a job. I haven't got enough time. And these pots here, I'm going to empty and fill with my Charlotte potatoes, which are in the greenhouse, shriveling away to nothing. But I haven't been able to plant them before because I didn't have any potato fertilizer. So they will probably go in those 10 litre pots, or maybe two will go in 30 litre pots. If we also look in the fairly tidy-ish shed, I have, these are pink fir, but I'm not planting them this year. We have some sarpomera under here. And they've got the white shoots on them. But what I'll do is I'll take the biggest ones like that, brush off the white shoots, and I'll probably plant about 8 of these just to keep the sarpomeras going as well. I should have put them to chit and I forgot about it. And the rest we'll eat in the next few weeks. I'm just planting up those sarpomeras. I'm just going to cover them over. And then I'll add them to the other three over there. And then we'll move on to the Charlottes. Finally, with my helpful assistant, we are planting the Charlotte potatoes into a 10 litre bucket.
I like doing this.
Here are the pots of Charlotte potatoes. 5 small ones and 2 big ones. 2 seed potatoes in the big ones and just 1 seed potato in the small ones. And then there's 4 pots of sarpomera, which I've got blue tags for them. And then these are the Maris Piper, which are red, and then down there are the Cara, which I did the other day. So all I've got to do now for these is give them a water and then put the straw on top. And the straw will keep the moisture in, hopefully, so they shouldn't dry out. The last job I'm going to do tonight is to sow some carrots and leeks. And I'm going to put them in between here because I think they'll fit quite nice in between the broad beans. So I've got early Nantes, Musselburgh leeks, and Amsterdam forcin. So I'll get on and sow these, and I'll bring you back when I'm done. Here's the patch, all tucked up for the evening. When I come back from Wales, I will put some mesh over it, some enviro mesh to keep out the leek miner and the carrot root fly. And then just over here, this is the last thing I'm doing tonight. I've just sowed some radish. in there. The variety is red globe. Well, that's it from me for today. I've really enjoyed getting a lot of the work done around the garden. I'm very pleased to have got my potatoes in. That always seems a big job, and once they're in, I'm always really pleased about it. And I'm also pleased to have got that bit of that patch done by my greenhouse that was bothering me every time I looked out of the window in the kitchen. So that bit looks tidy now, and I've just discovered I got some leeks, which is a bonus. So that is it from me for today. Thank you for watching, liking, subscribing and commenting if you've done so. I really appreciate it. And all I can say about my work today is lovely job. Take care, everybody, and hopefully I'll see you on the next one.
Lovely job.